So, hello, it's time for Onii-chan, the Twitter's most beloved anime. Yeah, this anime is very popular, I feel. You know, I love genderbender animes, but obviously, I feel, to some extent, when I watch the anime, it's because I do love everyone hating it, right? And I say everyone, you know, clientele and virtue. But of course, it is funny to read people's annual tweets about it and so on. Definitely, I feel. I'm the kind of guy who's like, oh yeah, this is extra. The meta of it makes it extra funny, right? But last episode was very dirty, though. Yeah, like, she's, you know, stalking her sister, right? Go take her on a date. So she goes in there, like, oh, she's like, you know, awesome date. I'm gonna figure out who's her boyfriend. See, it's a guy, Rudy. It's like, oh, it's a girl. Then go home, sister, like, oh, but they're probably doing it. And then, yeah, see, it shows them having it. Ooh, that scene was just crazy. And it actually shows them doing it. Yeah, you're like, what? What? It's one thing that she's like, oh, I think our sisters are a lesbian couple, right? It's one thing that having a character, of course, saying, oh, I think our sisters are in love. Yeah, you know, yeah. But they're showing it. You're like, yeah, okay, they're definitely doing it, okay. And then later on, of course, she sort of kissing her and so on. Yeah, so the episode was very Yuri. Let's watch next episode. So 3, 2, 1, and go. But of course, the anime is a rom-com, gender bender, right? And Christmas is very typical romance in anime, so in that sense, though, it wasn't too surprising that of kissing. Yeah, but here we go. It's still Christmas, I guess. Yeah, it's like cold. Yeah, exactly. Should I say that? Yeah, it's cold still, so this is like, I guess, in January. Yeah, he's complaining about having to wear a skirt, right? Yeah, goddamn, being a girl, having to have a skirt on. Yeah, but I guess it's like January, maybe February now. Yeah. Ohio. She's a GYARU, so yeah, she's gonna represent. Yeah! I'm an old GYARU! She's like, if you wanna be a cute girl, you gotta get through the pain! Yeah. Yeah, how can you wear that when you're a child? She's like, I gotta look hot, you know, I'm a hot GYARU. Gotta shake my ass, you know, yeah. She's like, I'm a professional GYARU, yeah, I'm a proud GYARU, you know, I can't get hide my sexy booty, yeah. Exactly, it's like super cold. That is a common issue though for a lot of women. Yeah. I know so many women, right? They would dress up, you know, or they would dress down, right? Even though it's cold. Like, I'm from Sweden, right? So, obviously, Sweden's very cold 7 months a year. And, yeah, it's opening. Doo-doo. But honestly, that is a pretty common issue, or common issue, but for the people, right? I heard so many times, right, from females I know in Sweden, right? You know, friends, classmates, whatever, right? That they're complaining about, oh, I need to dress in this, you know, like, you know, revealing outfit with big, my tits are coming out, and, you know, a very short, and, oh, it's so cold because, like, minus 30 degrees or whatever, right? Sweden is very cold sometimes, right, yeah. So it's like, you know, it's like a blizzard outside, and they're, you know, going to a party in, like, December, and they dress up as a prostitute, you know what I mean? Then they complain about it. But my take on it is always like, why are you complaining about it, idiot? Yeah, I've said it to many people. That's why I was so popular among the ladies. No, but seriously, I was like, why are you complaining about it? You know, no one forced you. Like, I literally been at a company, you know, typically you have a Christmas party or even two of them usually in Sweden, right? A very, very big thing in Sweden is the Christmas party, right? You know, julbord is called, yeah. Incredibly big thing in Swedish culture is julbord. So I've had colleagues, you know, like a 35-year-old woman, right? You know, a grown-ass woman, right? Grown up, you know. Wait, you know, a career, an education, like a master's degree, whatever, right? High paid salary, right? And she's coming there dressed out as a hooker, right? Basically, right? For the Christmas party, right? Because she wants to be hot and maybe, you know, seduce a coworker or whatever, yeah. And then she complained to me, ah, it's so unfair. You guys, you can dress like this and I'm coming here in, you know, short. And I'm like, no one forced you to come here in, you know, a super revealing top so we can see your pantsuit. No one forced you. You're a 35-year-old, well-educated woman with like a really high salary, like six-figure salary. No one forced you to come in here looking like you're working in the night shift. No. No one forced you, okay? Like, I've had this conversation many times with women, seriously, in Sweden. Not much in Japan, but in Sweden. Not in America either, but it's like a Swedish thing, I guess, because Swedes love to complain about the weather too, yeah. Swedes love, here you go, Moskosh, yeah. But yeah, Swedes love to complain about the weather, so it's very common finding women complaining that, oh, yeah, oh my god, now she's showing her skirt to everyone, yeah. Yeah, you boy, you boys, you perfs! She go! eyes. Like, stupid Onii-chan is looking at my shirt. What a scene. She basically showed her pantsuit to them. And then the girls were like, you pervs. And like, what? She was the one like, look at my short skirt. Yeah, she's the one that's like, oh, it's so cold in this skirt. She was the one showing her panties to them. And why are you blaming the poor guys for? Stupid boys looking at her panties. Like, she flashed us. Man, those poor guys, man. They always get bullied by her. Yeah, now she's talking about different skirts here. Well, that's a skirt episode. Yeah, episode about skirts now. Yeah, it's like, but sure, it's like I thought about, right? You know? Gonna have a hot, but also, you know, keeping you warm a skirt. Yeah, a skirt that's both hot, actually hot, like practical hot, and a skirt is hot as an attractive way. Right? But I will say it again, though, generally. I've been there so many times, like co-workers, classmates, and so on, women complaining about having too short of a skirt and so on. And it's always about her oppas. Yeah, she got big oppas, so that's a big thing in the anime, to touch her oppas. Yeah, that's gonna heat you up at least. Yeah, it's like in the last episode of Damashi, it's gonna get that hot going, man. Grab those pillows. Man, I don't know, man. This is weird, man. The friendships are weird, anime, as always. Yosh. I can't drop it now. I have so many memories of this. Oh my god, I catch it, anime. I have so many memories of people complaining about. What is this? The guy who's back attacking us. Yeah! Booyah! Two big ninis! Yeah, this is about Urika. Yeah, Urika, she's like. Yeah, kawaii! This anime is so perverted, Jesus Christ. She wakes up suddenly in giant titties, yeah. I'm drowning! He's like, how did I get here? Yeah, but I like how this guy is a weird man, yeah, because she was sleeping, you know, it's not like she wakes up in her body, yeah, she's clearly a perv. She's the one that was like, put her in on her titties, yeah. She's the one that was like, put her on the lap, oppai positioning. Because it was cute, yeah. So she's clearly trying to get some, right? Yeah, she's the one that's like put her in him in the positioning. But that's what I mean. It reminds me of Urukasha because it's not the same thing. Yeah, with her massive oppies. That's the exact same thing, yeah. But one thing those anime, I think I said it earlier, right? Is that the sister is a gender bender scientist, right? Yet she never does anything with her scientific skills, except, of course, obviously make her brother to that woman, but I mean, yeah, now her friend here is studying, and she doesn't help her. I mean, isn't her sister supposed to, isn't her girlfriend, I guess, her girlfriend's supposed to be a genius. Yeah, she's like, why don't you help her? She's supposed to be a genius. But doesn't she either do her own math or something, or... Man, this anime, oh my god, this character... Yeah, wow! Yeah, this anime. Every god I've seen, man, this guy was like, look at my titties! Yeah, it's like this anime. Every scene is like, I got gigantic oppies! Yeah, you don't say. Yeah, okay, they're gonna give a massage. Oh, yeah, it turns into a weird Yuri. It turned into like a hentai scene. Yeah, Yuri scene, of course it did. Let me give you a massage! She's like, yeah! That doesn't look like a normal, and this is the brother, like, this doesn't look like a normal massage at all. This looks like a scene out of a hentai, yeah, he's just like, you two definitely do have intercourse, right? Yeah, it's like, yeah. Oh, what? And now they're like, spread your legs for me, woman. What? Man, this anime is perverted, man. He's like, spread them. Yeah, of course it's a massage, but Jesus Christ. Yeah! Oh, nannies! It's like, what am I watching? It turned into a Yuri scene. Hardcore. This anime is so Yuri, man. Yeah, spread them! He's like, it's your time now, brother. Like, he's trying to escape here. He's like, she's gonna arm me. She's gonna arm me, definitely. He's an arm scene now. She's gonna hand tie me. Dummy! Man, this anime is so crazy. And of course, she's like, yeah, you're gonna get it now, boy. Exactly, you're gonna get it now. Yeah. Man, this anime is crazy, man. Nani, this anime is weird. But yeah, like she flipped the sister over and was like, spread them. And like smacked her legs open. That was a weird scene, man. That's a weird scene. Yeah, that was, you know, typical massage. Yeah, this is like every hentai massage ever. Yeah, that's. But of course, I mean, it is a very common plot point, right? And also, I guess. Oh yeah, her sister also, of course, gets it every night. They're like, okay, that sounds pretty weird. Oh, Mars, now it's her doing like the eye catches anime. It's going crazy. Yeah, that is her like doing the hula hoop rings with her gigantic oppies. Yes. Oh, this anime is so itchy. It's like the eye catcher is the gigantic breast lady like shaking it in the hula hoop rings. Yeah, you're like, yeah, of course it is. Like is there her succubus eye catcher see the. Now he wakes up, eats chocolate. Yeah, he is a terrible person, that's a terrible, I guess, diet, right? Yeah, imagine waking up eating like chocolate, like immediately, like, ah, chocolate. Some probably does that, but I can't really see myself doing that. I will admit that I, if waking up in my life, having like, I guess, a camp, the last school decision, if I had some from like a party, maybe, right, then the next morning waking up being, you know, kind of hangover, like, where am I? Last school days, yeah, or like. Some half-eaten food from there. Yeah, that's probably more like, you know, having a pizza that I haven't eaten up yet since last party, you know, like waking up in the morning, you know, it's like, where's everyone? Some food, just eating something random like that. Like, have you hangover or something? Yeah, I guess. But not like just waking up being like, oh, candy! I have a chocolate bar next to me in the bedroom. No, that seems really bad behavior. Oh my god, it's chocolate. So this is, of course, Japan. This means they're a couple now. Yeah, psycho, so they're basically married now. Yeah, so in Japan, right, you get chocolate if you're romantically interested, right? You can, of course, tell, you can give them, like, friendship chocolate too, but this is clearly, like, a romantic chocolate, yeah. So it's, you see a lot of animes, right, how they give chocolate, and it's like, you know, if by doing that, the girl is, like, telling the boy she wants to smash, right? Yeah, it's very, very common. It's very common in Japan, right, for Valentine, yeah. So you get the chocolate today, so yeah. But everyone gives it to him, of course, because he's very adorable, so everyone wants to smash him, right? Yeah, all the girl wants him. Domo domo, yeah. All the girl wants him, yeah, he's very attractive. Yeah, he got a collection now of chocolate. Yeah. They all want to smash. Oh my god! He got it from another girl! Yeah, and I saw there's some romance there. Yeah, she gave it to one of the. That girl, I don't even know her name, but she gave it to the sleepy guy. The blue haired guy that sleeps a lot. Yeah, there's a guy that sleeps too much, right? So. And now she gives it to everyone because she has so much to give. She got so much herself, she can keep giving it out to other people. Yeah, she's like a chocolate rubber baron now. Yeah, a chocolate baron. Oh my god, she's gonna have so much love interest now. Oh yeah, all these poor guys getting nothing. And he's gonna be all like, I feel sorry for them. I'm gonna save them. Yeah, he's obviously gonna be like, I need to give all those guys chocolate because they have no girlfriend. I need to be there for them. I know that feeling. Yeah, I know the feeling. Here we go. Hey, cute guys. It's like, hey, cuties. I like it. He's gonna come in and be like, yeah, you want some chocolate? Because he knows how to have a girlfriend. Yeah, so he's like, I know how to be a man. Yeah, like, I mean. I need to give them pit chocolate. Exactly, he's gonna come over to be all flirty because he feels sorry for all the poor guys having their girlfriends, yeah. Who's this guy? I love this man that he's like, I need to give everyone chocolate because I feel sorry for them. Who's this guy? Like a huge muscle guy? No, they all want her, right? Yeah, yeah, or him, yeah, they all want his body. Yeah, no, they all want the chocolate. They all want the cute girl now. These poor guys, man. These girls are back earlier. These are the girls that called the guys pervs earlier. These are back. They're like, yeah, they were protecting her. These are the girls that were like, you perverts. And they're like, we used. She was the one that gave us stuff. Yeah, it's like, you know. But yeah, I like it. He giving the other guys petty chocolates in pity because he's like, I know how it is to be single, having no girlfriend. I gotta help the guys and pretend to be the girlfriend. Yeah, that is so him though. That's like typical him storyline. Yeah, with one of the guys turning to a woman and, you know, being everyone's girlfriend, right? To like, you know, support them. Yeah. basically. How did it go? Oh, I got drowned in chocolate. All the girls wants me. All the guys wants me. I got like 30 boys slash girlfriends. Yeah, it's like, yeah, of course you do. Oh, I got the sister chocolate. The most important one. The family relationship. Yes. Relationship. Family. Oh, of course, she prepared for his sister. I mean, a heart and everything. Man, this anime is dirty, man. My sister can't be this cute, you know, yeah. Yeah, my sister can't just be this cute. Kind of not cute anymore, she's trying, but... Ooh, there we go. Onii-chan in a bunny suit. Yeah, the eye catches are very good, though. Those two girls, those were the girls that gave the older guy chocolate that we haven't seen before, yeah. They had some other romance going on. Okay, who's this woman? Some new character? Yeah, it's like a salesperson. Yeah, it's a new woman. Ah, whatever. I guess not an important character. He needs to buy his new hell stuff, right? He's gonna be like, I need to buy some Ero mangas. Yeah, I need to buy something with some boobs and ass. And he's like, we're cracking up by some. I'm just imagining the shopkeeper is like, you're too young to be allowed to buy this. Yeah, because he looks like he's very short, right? Maybe it's gonna be hard for him to buy some, you know, Ero stuff. Exactly, here we go. Now it's gonna be like, that's what I wait for, right? I probably can't go in there now. Oh, can I? That would be kind of funny. Yeah. I mean, I shouldn't, but I really should. I really want to. It's like, I really want to go in there, though. Ah, he was the guy from the class, definitely. Come on. It's my classmates. Yeah, he was the guys. They want to buy some Mr. Hentai stuff. Of course, he's like, I respect them. he's like, that's boys for you. It's respect. Yeah, it's like, oh no. Now the guys are gonna realize that he saw them. And they're gonna be like, oh no, she saw us. Yeah, she saw us buying hentai. That's the thing that I don't know. So it's okay, guys. I don't judge. Yeah, it's okay. You can buy hentai. I support you guys. <It's> like, I didn't mean to scare you guys. Sorry. It's her, of course. Big opile. It's me, opile lady. Ah, now you say it, yeah. No, she thinks that he wants hentai, of course. She go! There was the guys from the class, yeah. Yeah, I tried to find the boy love stuff. Yeah, exactly, the boy love stuff. But it's a classic excuse, man. No, I'm here for the yaoi stuff. I would go in there at 18. I don't want about the yaoi stuff. Yeah, like, because yaoi is like, I guess, the softcore yaoi is 18 plus. Yeah, no, I'm here for the, you know, boy love stuff. Yeah, boy love. Yeah, that's what I'm for. Typical yaoi mangas, that's what I'm for, yeah. Without the actual fun stuff, yeah. But yeah, the boy love section is next to the daughter. You know, this reminds me when I was in Copenhagen a couple years ago, many years ago. But anyway, I was there. They have this huge manga and anime. Yeah, it's like a, they got a lot of stuff. Okay. But I was there anyway in their manga section. They have four different stores. They sell different like anime and manga stuff and so on. And like comic books, but I was in the manga store then with my colleagues. So we went there. My colleague wanted to go to this place, right? Huge place in Copenhagen. But the manga store or the novel store, whatever, it was basically half 50% of this boy love stuff. And so I asked the woman who worked there. I was like, "You seem to have a lot of yaoi mangas." And she was like, "That is what sells though." So she's like, "Yeah, that sells like butter." So we got like, they got like 10 shelves in the basement. And like 5 of them was like boy love stuff. And the other 5 was like Demon Slayer or whatever. Yeah. You know, like the current popular manga, right? But the rest of it is like boy love stuff. And she was like, "Oh yeah, it sells so well. We only sell yaoi manga." And I was like, "Do you have any Yuri manga? I always wonder, I don't buy Yuri manga, but do you have some Yuri manga or light novels?" She's like, "Yeah, we got like one half line over there, but who cares? Yaoi stuff." It's like, that's what I think is happening in Scandinavia. people only buy the yaoi stuff. Yeah, it says like hot butter, man. No one buys the yuri stuff. But anyway, yeah. So it's gonna be some French stuff. Some crepe. Yeah. Yeah, the first time I went to Paris, the kid, probably the first time I ate this. Yeah. They do sell it in the... I see if it's in Gothenburg, Stockholm too. But I think as a kid, the first time I ate this kind of food was... When I was in Paris, when I was 6 years old, first time I was in Paris, first time. Yeah, that was probably the first time I ate crepes. Oh no, now it's indirect kissing. Oh no. It's Yuri. Yeah, it turned into Yuri again here. It turned into Yuri. You two are doing it! That's my girlfriend! Yeah, it turned into like a Netherrealm scene. Yeah, basically, yeah. That's my girlfriend you kissing over there! Yeah, it turned into a Netherrealm scene. Yeah, you kissing my girlfriend over there! Yeah, like it's... They're like, yeah, indirect kissing here. I also want one! Yeah, it's like, I also want to kiss my girlfriend! Yeah, and she's like, damn it. She blocked my kiss there, yeah. Oh, I don't mind it. Come on, she's like a stupid tomboy. She's like a muscular, genki girl. And she also wants it kissing now, yeah. Exactly! Eat my eye in the eye touch first! Indirect kissing! Like, eat it! I had it in my mouth! Now you lick it! He's like, what? Yeah, she's poor. She also gets indirect kissing though. But now she's getting a lesbian for everyone here. Yeah, this turned into a lesbian scene though. She's getting Yuri for everyone. But they all already ate that, so it's turning into Yuri. Yeah, this is a Yuri scene. It looks kawaii, but it's actually very Yuri right there. Because they all already kissed that, so... Not all four of them have kissed each other here. It turned into a typical Yuri gang here, yeah. They all have kissed everyone now, yeah. It's turned into a weird, Yeah, oh, she's like, I love all of you guys! You're my best guys! Yeah, it's like, I love all of you! It made it even worse, she's like, I love you girls! Now she's just like, openly like, I love you! Okay, yeah, now it made even more Yuri. But a lot of those guys, though, are trying to buy some hentai there. Are they gonna ask her to be... They're gonna be like, please don't tell us you saw us at the hentai place! I'm judging! I am hentai! She's just like trying to be like, no! You guys wanna buy those stuff? Oh, that's fine! Yeah, it's like... We were used to examining it! We were gonna buy some hen stuff? Come on, girl! We were... you know! Right, these poor guys. Makata, I don't care. I'm pro hand stuff. You know, don't worry, guys. I will die with this secret. It's my secret. Yeah, she didn't get them. It's a secret, cuties. Now we turn into. But now they're like, she's kind of hot after all. Yeah. Now. Stop thinking about me doing it. Yeah. Yeah, like, you dirty secret. It's a secret with me, boys. Of course, you're gonna come and ask her not to tell them, or him, them, or her. Them. Yeah, let's go back to the scene before there. That's beautiful. I love the scene when she spots them going into the hen place, yeah, to buy 18 plus mangas, right? And then she is trying not to just stop them. And she's like, no. You guys buy your hen stuff? That's cool. Yeah. And she's trying to like, no, don't run away. I think it's cool that you guys buy hen stuff. What's that scene? Oh, that was so adorable. It's like, no, I'm not against buying hen stuff. Don't run. here it is. Okay, I'll find it here. Last panel. Here. Yeah, they're standing there. She's all like, he's all like, oh yeah, that's my guys. Like, he's all proud of them. Oh, they're buying hen stuff? Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, and then they're running away. Yeah, I rewatched it again there. Yeah, and I like this. Yeah, I love this scene. And he's like, no, don't run! No, he's awesome! You should buy some hen stuff! Hen is for the good. Yeah. No, but it was so cute because, of course, you know, we know, of course, that this adorable lady is actually, of course, a man, right? That's quite the perv, right? So obviously, as we know, he is pro hen stuff. He got a bunch of collections, right? He was just himself thinking to enter the place and buy some hen stuff, right? Buy some Yuri or Yaoi, whatever, right? And then those guys are like, yeah. Now I'm just gonna tell him, he thinks we are pervs. It's like, no, don't run! I also buy hen stuff. Oh, this is adorable, man. This is adorable. Trying to help them. But yeah, the massage thing was very Yuri. Of course, the guy was always showing her massive tatas, right? And there was some scenes where she was squeezing her own tatas and so on. So that was kind of etchy. And especially when she flipped over her girlfriend. She's like, move, spread your legs, lady. No, we know they're dating, right? The kiss last episode. So, I mean, they're already a date. They're a couple, so sure. But still, that scene was kind of like, he flipped her over like, let me touch you. You're like, what? That scene was etchy, man. That scene was etchy. And yeah, and chocolate scene, of course. Chocolate scene was pretty funny. I mean, it's kind of common, I feel, for this gender, but anyways, the main character, everyone's also smashed them, right? Everyone, boys and girls. So, of course, he gets, like, drowned in chocolate, right? And like I said earlier, like, typical anime, right? Typical, very common anime, Japanese culture, is that, of course, you give chocolate on Valentine's Day, so if you like the guy, you can also give, like, you know, friendship chocolate, basically, right? Duty chocolate. But it feels like everyone gives the main character, like, you know, romantically chocolate, right? but I love the scene too that I said earlier. I love this scene when he was giving chocolate to the guys though. Yeah, he's like, I also been a single guy, you know, having no girlfriend, so I can be your girlfriend for one day. That again feels very hentai. That I feel like 50% of the hentais with gender bended starts like that, right? Where the guy is like, oh, I will pity my former friends, you know, I'm a woman now, so I can pretend to be your girlfriend for one day or something, or I can kiss you used to. You can get a squeeze for free or whatever. I feel like 15 of the gender bender hand stuff does start like that. Yeah, and it's like, I will give them some chocolate because I feel sorry for them. I've been there myself, you know. And now they guys are like, oh, she's so attractive. It ends with them, you know, obviously being in love with... again, they really liked him earlier, though. Yeah, they were in love with him earlier with the nerd stuff, though. But still. But yeah, I guess this episode, not a funny, somewhat controversial episode, as always, right? I guess soon with Loom as well. And also have a great day.